Hi, I'm Jesse with Metroline Direct, and in this video I will be showing you how to program your Polycom IP phone, and specifically we'll be covering the dial plan or digit mat, and we'll be programming it from a web browser. Now this is good for individual phones, but if you have a lot of phones it can also be programmed from configuration files. Before we get started, I just want to mention that if you find this video helpful, can you do us a favor and click on the like button at the bottom of the video? Now with these phones, these are versatile phones, so they can connect to a hosted provider, or you can have them connecting to a phone system such as IPOffice, FreePBX, Panasonic, or any number of other systems that allow a SIP connection. So in this video we'll be covering connecting the phone to your phone system. I already found the IP address of the phone, and when you get to the administration page of the phone, it will ask for a password. And the default password is 456. For the digit mat, I'm going to click on Settings, and then SIP. And here's the default digit mat. This would work with a hosted SIP provider. It would allow you to dial external phone numbers like 911, 7-digit numbers, 10-digit numbers. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to delete that out of there, and I'll just enter in the numbers manually here. So for a lot of people's phone systems, they dial 9 for an outside line. You can change that on your phone system typically. Maybe you want to use 8 or something like that. So in this case we'll stick with 9, and then I'm going to put in some brackets and put in 2-9, close bracket. And this would be a match if someone dialed 9911, because 2-9 inside the brackets tells the phone any number dialed between 2 and 9 is a match. So that means that would also cover if someone dialed 9811 or 9411, those types of numbers. But let's say someone forgets to dial the leading 9, or they don't know that they have to dial that 9. We should put in an entry to match that. So we're going to put in a pipe, that's the straight up and down line, and then type in 911, and then we'll do another pipe. The pipes are separators, and these are typically on your keyboard. It's going to be the straight up and down line next to the backspace at the top of your keyboard. Next, I'll add an entry to allow for 7-digit local calls. So I'll add 9 and 2-9 in brackets, followed by 6 X's, and followed by dot T. And this should be a capital T. The dot or period and capital T tell the phone to wait for possibly more digits, such as a 10-digit number for long distance. Now you may need to program your PBX system to add the area code in for you, depending on your setup. If you need help with that part, you can give us a call. Next we'll add another pipe, and we'll make an entry for dialing long distance. And you'll notice I put 9 followed by 2-9 in brackets. So this would allow for dialing a 10-digit number without dialing the 1. A lot of people are used to this type of dialing from their cell phones. And now I'll add the same entry, except I'll have a 1 following the 9 in case someone is used to dialing the 1 before the area code. The next option I'll add will be for international calls. For international calls, we'll do a 9011 followed by 3 X's and dot T. And again, this would allow you to call numbers that start with 011, which would be for international calls. The last option I want to add is for dialing extension numbers. Since I'm dialing 9 for an outside line in this case, My extension numbers can start with anything between 1 and 8, so I'll add 1-8 in brackets. So let's say I have 3-digit extensions, I would add 2 more X's, and that would allow for any number between 1 and 8 followed by 2 more digits to be dialed. But let's say I have 3-digit and 4-digit extensions. What I can do is add in a capital T, and that will tell the phone to wait for one additional digit. So if you notice, I have 7 individual sections in my digit map, so that means I need to have 7 timeouts in my digit map timeout. You can make this any number, but the default number is 3 for each of these. That means that there will be a 3-second timeout for each of these sections. Now, in order to save it, we need to scroll down to the bottom, click on the Save button, and then click on Yes. Changes to the digit map field does not require the phone to reboot. However, changes to the digit map timeout will require the phone to reboot. Well, that's our video for today. Now you know how to program the digit map on a Polycom IP phone when you're using a PBX phone system. I hope you found that helpful. If so, please click the like button at the bottom of the video, and if you'd like to see more videos, click the subscribe button. Again, I'm Jesse with MetroLine Direct. Thanks for watching.